I've touched on this before, but I think it bears repeating. So I'm going to talk about why you probably should stop looking for new gear if you are. Hey guys, welcome back, or if this is your first time here, my name is Brandon, and welcome to A Place for Melodic Metal Guitarists. Well, today I am going to talk about gear. Who doesn't like gear? I mean, everybody likes gear. I love gear. I want to tell you kind of a story that happened very recently. So for those who have been around for just a few weeks, you know that I just got Seymour Duncan pickups for my 8-string guitar. Now, what this all started back when I watched several videos on Instagram by Jesse Cash. You know, he is the vocalist and the lead guitarist of Era, and that's one of the bands that I like listening to. And he has a really beautiful 7-string guitar made by Ibanez. It's kind of this greenish look on the body style. It's just really nice looking. So as I watched him play that guitar, I thought, is there any way that I could possibly have that same guitar? I'm like, well, but then again, I want it in an 8-string version. They don't make that. There's not very many 8-strings out there that I would be happy to have because they're all black, and I'm kind of sick of the black color. So I thought, well, maybe I can get something custom made. And so I went on this tangent for like a week, justify some way to get a new 8-string guitar. And I thought, well, maybe I should go back to a 7-string guitar so I could have that. And there was all these things that I wanted. I wanted this, a guitar with fan frets, you know, passive pickups, all these different things. And then finally I decided, you know what? Why am I doing this? I have a perfectly working 8-string guitar. If I want a slightly different sound, let's just get new pickups. So that's when I opted for getting new pickups for the 8-string because I had turned it into an active guitar and I wanted passive pickups. So long story short, after going to passive pickups, I got the sound I wanted without spending a ton of money. So in the end, I spent a little over $300, whereas I probably would have spent $1,000 or more to get some other guitar that I didn't need. If you have gear already, then you likely already have all you need to make music like you want to. If you have a guitar and you have an interface, there you go, that's all you need. There's free software out there to give you a good amp sound that you're looking for. I did it again just the other day. I was looking up some new software, new amp sims that I was thinking of buying. I was about to drop, I think, almost $100 on it or more. I thought, wait a second, there are free options out there. And I've already invested a lot of money in Easy Mix, trying to sound better, get better tones. I never am satisfied. Every single time I get new gear, I always want more. And that is why if you have just enough gear to get started, if you have just the bare minimum, don't let that stop you from making music. Don't always think, okay, if I could just get this guitar, if I could get this microphone, if I could get this amp or this piece of software, I could be really awesome at making music and mixing music. I'd be all of a sudden just better, just like that. And the truth is, no, probably not. Now, I have had people argue that yes, sometimes it depends. Sometimes gear can make you better. Okay, what I'm talking about is obsessing over new gear all the time. You know, I have to restrain myself, and sometimes I've unsubscribed from channels where musicians are always getting new gear, and that's just because they're in a position that they can get it, that they can afford it, and maybe they're sponsored by a lot of companies, and you know, the companies want to get their name out there, so they'll contact this YouTuber who's got all this stuff, and I'm like, man, if only I could like get all that stuff. And I'm like, no, wait a second. Do I have a guitar? Yes. Do I have amps? Yes, and my software. Do I have a digital audio workstation? Yes, I have Reaper. You have everything you need, Brandon. You have everything you need. So this is not just preaching to you, this is preaching to me, because I go through this all the time, wanting new gear. And it's just something that you have to, as a musician, withhold from yourself. And here's another thing. If you don't have the money to go out and buy things. Do not surf the web on music sites. Do not go to Guitar Center. I haven't been to Guitar Center in I don't know how long. It's probably been almost a year, if not a year, because I don't have anything that I need. All this, the strings and the picks that I've needed, I just order those online. If I go into Guitar Center just to say I'm going to look, I will rationalize some purchase. Oh, I could use these guitar strings for a rainy day. What if the apocalypse happens and I don't have any guitar picks? I get all these picks, I get 70 picks just in case. You know, just something that I don't even need. A new guitar tuner, that's another thing. I've got plenty of tuners everywhere. I don't need all that stuff. So that's why I try to stay out of places like Guitar Center. And so anyway, for all that to say this, if you don't have money in your budget to shop, don't do it, because you'll end up rationalizing a purchase unless you're stronger than I am. I don't look when I don't need anything, because I start to try to figure out a reason, I'd say rationalize why I may need that piece of gear. And so this is one of my problems. I have everything I need. Yes, new gear is fine. Even goes back to say, okay, well, Brandon, you had those EMG pickups in your 8-string guitar. Did you really need Seymour Duncan pickups? No, I didn't need it, but it had been a while since I've made a big purchase, and I really was sick of the active sound of my 8-string. I didn't have as much clarity, and I thought, well, if I'm gonna do something to get a different sound, I might as well do something a little bit cheaper. In any case, yes, you know, some people may make the argument and say, well, you didn't even need to get the Seymour Duncan pickups. It sounds like you were making music just fine. You sounded great. Nobody really knows the difference. Well, that's okay. You know, you could even apply this to music and bands. I mean, I already have so many CDs as it is, and I say CDs, they're really not, they're actually just digital. I try to limit the amount of music that I listen to and buy. If I can listen to it on YouTube, I will, because I'll end up, that's another thing, I'll end up spending so much money. You know, although it'd be awesome to have enough money to purchase every single artist that I hear, that I enjoy, it's just not realistic. And so I have to limit myself whenever I make purchases of bands and things. In fact, Red is one of my most favorite bands, and for the first time in a long time, I only made a single purchase from them. I usually pre-order their stuff with like a bunch of different things, shirts and all that stuff. This time around, I just didn't have really the money to spend a whole bunch, and so I didn't pre-order their stuff. I just ended up just going to Best Buy and buying a $10 CD. You just kind of have to look at your own life and your own journey wherever you are. You know, you may be just starting out. You may only have a guitar and a cheap amp. You might want to eventually upgrade, but honestly, you can get by these days with very little. I have heard of bands, Fireflight is one of them that I'm thinking of right now, that recorded a whole album on a little bitty tiny Cube amp. I couldn't believe that that's where their tone was coming from. So that just goes to show that even cheap stuff you can make good music with. You don't have to have a lot of money. You don't have to have a lot of gear to make it happen. Anyway, I hope you understand my point, and I think most of you do. If you have comments or things that you would like to add, please leave those in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you, and share this with your friends, especially if you have those who are always looking at new gear. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I know it was a lot different than usual, but I just had to get this off my chest. So I hope I will see you back next Saturday, and I hope all of you have a great weekend. Thank you.